Hello, my name is Jiyoung Lim, and I'm a graduate student of Professor Jiho Park's lab. Today's lecture topic is about an anti-cancer strategy by modulating the cancer cell signaling. Today's speaker is Sangwon Kang. He is a professor at Ewha Women's University Department of Life Science. And he has been working on cell signaling research mainly on the ROS and the redox signaling in cells. So let's look up on current drug therapies for cancer cells. These are the various kinds of drugs. Some of it is on the clinical trial and some of it is already registered. Most of them work as kinase inhibitor. Since phosphorylation is the major regulation mechanism of cell signaling, kinase inhibitors can regulate a variety of cell functions. But the main point of this lecture is to propose another kind of mechanism with reactive oxygen species to kill cancer cells. So I review important concepts of reactive oxygen species in here. Reactive oxygen species are broadly defined as oxygen-containing reactive chemical species. And there are two kinds of ROS. One is free radical, which has unpaired electrons. You can see red dots as unpaired electrons in superoxide and hydroxyl radical. And the other one is non-radical ROS, which doesn't have unpaired electrons on it. ROS have various functions. They are involved in cell growth, differentiation, enzyme activity, inflammation, and immune response. And because ROS are highly reactive, it can damage cells by causing irreversible oxidative damage to DNA, proteins, and lipids. The major source of ROS is the mitochondria. From respiratory chain, electron leakage causes generation of ROS. So, how does ROS related with cancers in our body? First, ROS can be generated by radiation, carcinogen, inflammation, and hypoxia. Then, ROS cause oxidative DNA damage. This damages increased genomic instability to become normal cells translated into cancer cells. After that, oncogene activation and mitochondrial dysfunction can further generate ROS, so this becomes a vicious cycle. If we see with the longer time scale, generation of ROS also causes other effects in cells. Adaptation to ROS can increase drug resistance and stronger survival mechanism for cancer cells. So today, Professor Kang will give a lecture about the new type of cancer treatment, which use ROS and redox signaling modulation to kill cancer cells. For example, there is peroxiredoxin 2 in our body, and it protects VEGFR2 by removing ROS. If we eliminate peroxiredoxin 2, VEGF signal cannot be transmitted to cancer cells and it causes damage to cells. Now let's move on to the main lecture. Thank you very much.